So, I'm Erwin. I work with Snow. It's a Linux consulting company. In my day job, I use stuff like Prometheus, Kubernetes, Grafana to do everything. But this is a talk that's a bit different scale than what we've heard so far. This is about my washing machine and the problems I have with my washing machine. If you take a look, this is a picture of my washing machine. As you can see, the estimated time of arrival is 2:45. So I think, okay, I take a look. I come back 2 minutes after it should be done, and it's 50 minutes left. I come back 10 minutes later, and there's still 10 minutes left. So in 5 minutes, it's only gone up 10 minutes. Almost half an hour after it should have been done, there's still 10 minutes left. So you can imagine that I'm quite frustrated with that. So I thought about how can I solve this. I thought about putting a camera in there, buying a new wash machine that has an API, but I'm also cheap, so I wanted to do it with stuff I had lying around already. So I thought about, let's get some monitoring on my power usage and determine if I can see from the graphs that come out of that if my washing machine is done. So this is the setup. This is a Raspberry Pi Zero. It uses a USB to P1 cable. The smart meters in the Netherlands support a P1 port, and there's a it's a protocol, there's libraries available for it, so I didn't have to write so much. And so all the data that the smart meter collects can be gathered on the Raspberry Pi. So this is what we have so far. I wrote an exporter in Go using the PROM HTTP library that gets the data from the P1 port and stores it in global variables, and then exposes those metrics to be scraped by Prometheus. I know it's global variables, but it's my pet project, so I feel like I can do whatever I want. This is open source, the links are at the end. So now we have an endpoint that we can scrape, and in comes Prometheus. Who here has used Prometheus? Okay, then I'm not sure if I need to introduce it, but Prometheus is a polling mechanism, so it scrapes endpoints and it takes some metrics and stores them and puts them in a nice time series database. And as you can see, this is the interface of Prometheus. And this is a graph of my power draw, as I called it, over 1 hour. And you can see some peaks. Here I'm using 4 kilowatts. That's probably because the oven is turned on. That uses 3 kilowatts, so there's some more going on, but I'm not sure what it is. So I put Prometheus on the other Intel NUC that I had lying around. So now we have the gathering. But the visualization of Prometheus is not stored, so you have to put your graphs new every time. So there comes Grafana. I made some graphs with that. As you can see, this is also a graph of my gas usage versus the temperature, because I was interested, if it's very cold outside, do I use more gas? As it turns out, I do not. It doesn't have a lot of influence. And I will talk some more about the bottom graph later on. So I put Grafana also on the Raspberry Pi Zero. It runs just fine. There's not a lot of users. So actually, all the data is collected there. So that perhaps it's a bit of a different scale as we had so far, but it runs just fine. I also wanted a method of looking at those graphs I created with Grafana. So in comes Caddy. Caddy is another open source project. It's a reverse proxy, but there's Let's Encrypt built in, so it's very easy to configure and you get TLS encryption. So now we have a small quiz. This is a graph. The washing machine was running somewhere around this timeline. And when do you think it was done? So if everyone that thinks it was done at A wants to put their hands up. Okay, that's not so much. Everyone who thinks it was done at B, put their hands up. And everyone who thinks it was done at C, put their hands up. Okay, so most people think C, about 90%. It's not. It was done after A. The B of the C cycle is the oven. It uses a lot of power, but then it turns off again and uses power. So that's. But it was done after A. But as you can already see, the graphs are not linear. There's not a clear cutoff point of when it was done. So I basically failed at getting notifications when my washing machine is done. So the main quest, I really failed. Too bad. I do have some nice graphs now of my power usage, and I have some insights in how it's all working. So this is one of the graphs I created. The smart meter exposes the current draw and also the total meter. So with Prometheus, it is possible to do a derivative of your graph. So this is the comparison between what the meter is reporting, what the current draw is. And as you can see, they do align. But there's a small difference between them, which also makes sense because the smart meter only reports its values every 20 seconds. So if something happens in between those 20 seconds or the nothing happens, is also not really consistent, not really sure what's going on. But you can also see this is at night and there's some peaks like every hour, 90 minutes. And I was wondering what could be drawing this power at night? Sorry, what is? Exactly. At one point, I was up at night, and I heard it turn on. I was like, oh, let's check on my phone, and I saw the power draw has actually peaked, so the fridge is making these peaks. Another graph, the smart meter reports the off-peak and the peak meter, and I found out that I have, two meters. I didn't even know that, but that's in here. And in the weekends, it's all off-peak. And I also noticed, Christmas is off-peak, apparently. January 1st is off-peak. So I now have insights in when I save money and when I don't save money. One of the downsides of this graph is you see the dates are in between, and I couldn't get Grafana to time shift the visualization, because, correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe that the 21st was Sunday, so now it looks like the 22nd is also off-peak, but it's actually the power usage of the Sunday, so there's some interesting things going on there. I think that's a combination of Prometheus and Grafana. And that was it already. These are the sources. The QR code links to the project page, so you can, if you found something interesting, you can take a picture.